that's good. Keep going, keep squatting. Good. Couple more. One more. Good. Okay, just roll your shoulders back for me. And forwards. Good. And take it to tap the inside of your feet for me. Let's do four more. Good. And then take it into shoulder rolls backwards. And change it to forwards. Good. Okay, let's take it into alternate high knees for me. Good, let's do four more. One, two, three, four. Good, then we're gonna go into side bends. And then from here, we'll reach out to the side as far out as you can and then switch sides. Good. Let's do two more. Reach out. Okay, then we'll go back to knee raises, but this time give your knee a little bit of a hook into your chest. Good. Four more. One, two, three, four. Good. Okay, stand. Feet just a little bit wider than hip width and then circle your hips for me. And then back in the other direction. Good. And then side to side. Good work. Okay, I'm going to take it back into those squats for me. So circle the arms, reach nice and tall. Two more. One more. Good. And then just circle your hips for me. So across the body and out. One more, and then switch sides for me. Back to the other side, this time go out and in. One more, and then switch sides. Good. One more. Good. Okay, just put your hands on your knees for me. Feet, just a little bit of a gap between your feet. Bend your knees and then circle your knees. Let's go back in the other direction. Good work. And then back to just tapping the inside of your feet, and we're nearly warmed up and ready to go. And last time, take it into alternate high knees. Four more. One, two, three, four. And relax. Okay, grab your mat. Okay, we're going to start with tabletops. So, like we do the reset in gravity yoga. So, feet are quite close into your bum, fingertips are facing in towards your body. And then we're going to inhale, push our hips up and drop our head back. We're going to exhale and down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Two more. Inhale up. Exhale down. Last one. Inhale up. Exhale down. Okay, over, flip over. Okay, we're going to do thoracic spine opening. So pop your hand by your ear, elbow towards the ground. And then I want you to twist and take your elbow up towards the ceiling for me. Let's do four more. One more. Good, and then switch sides. So the other hand by the ear. So elbow points down towards the ground and then twist up. Two more. One more. And then take it back into child's pose for me. Just pause here. And I want you to come up and take your right arm across to the left side of the mat. And then just with that one arm, sit back into child's pose. You get a slightly different stretch. Okay, come back up, switch the other arm, left arm over to the right side of the mat, and then sit down. Okay, back into the center of both hands, regular child pose. Let's do one more time, right hand over to the left side of the mat and sit back. And then left hand over to the right side, sit back. Good. And then from here, we'll transition into cat and cow. So on all fours, I want you to inhale into cat position, really arch the back. And then exhale into cow. Inhale into cat. Exhale into cow. Let's just keep going at your own pace. So inhale when you're doing to cow and then exhale into cow. When you draw that belly button up towards your spine in cat and then arch that back into cow. Let's do one more. And yeah, relax. Okay, we're going to roll over onto your tummy. We're going to do reverse scorpion. We've done this before, so hands are out to the side. I'm going to lift my left heel and bring it over towards, as if I'm aiming for my right hand. I'm not going to hit it. And then reverse. Okay, and keep that going. I feel quite tight to do this all today. Let's do four more. And relax. Oh, that one felt super, super tight today. Let's see what we're doing. Okay, we're going to go into, it's similar to wild thing, but it's slightly different. So fingertips for this one are facing in towards your body, or you can face out, wherever you feel most comfortable with your hands. Okay, you're going to push the hips up towards the ceiling, but instead of taking the hand back like we're doing wild thing, we're going to come across the body like this, then down. Push up and across the body and down. Keep going. Okay. Let's do four more. One, two, three, four more, and four, and relax. Okay, lie down onto the ground. Bring your, take your left hand onto your right knee, and then just bring it across towards your left shoulder and get a nice stretch in the glute. And just hold that stretch for me a second. And then switch sides, so take your left knee with your right hand across towards your right shoulder, feel that stretch. Now I just want you to alternate sides, you're going to pause for a couple of seconds and then switch sides. So you pull across to the opposite shoulder, switch sides. Let's do four more. Two more. Last one. And recover. Good. Okay. Coming up onto your feet for me. Just move this mat out of the way. So if you have a DMS mat, you can use it. If you don't, that's fine. Then we're going to do the windmill. So feet are wider than hip width. Slightly wider than what you would do if you were going to do a squat. And take your arms up nice and wide. I'm going to bend my knees with my right hand, keep my right arm straight. I'm going to touch my left foot, come back up, and then change. Good. Not bending the knee too much, just enough to enable you to touch the toe. Legs are pretty straight. All right, two more. One more. And recover. Good. Okay, grab your wooden pole or your broomstick. Okay, go quite wide with your arms for me. I want you to take, if you can, go all the way over and back. It doesn't matter if you can't or you get a better stretch by maybe going narrower, but just going to there. So I'm going to work there. So I'm going to come narrow. So I feel a nice stretch along my chest. Move back as far as is comfortable and come forwards. Do two more, one more. Good, okay, this time drop it behind your head and we're just gonna rotate side to side. Okay, back to the center. I want you to go over to the side and back up. Over to the side and back up. Two more. One more. And relax. You can pop that to the side. We'll come back to that in a second. Okay, now we're going to have your feet just a gap between your feet as if we were going to do ragdoll, so we will in a second. So what you're going to do is go down to the side, down to the other side, and then you're going to fall forward into ragdoll and then slowly curl up and then go side to side. So don't rush it, go at your own pace. Keep your legs almost straight and touch down. If you have any problems with your lower back, then obviously bend the knees more. And then get your head in nice and close to your knees or your thighs as you go down into that bottom position. Don't rush this, just nice and steady. Yeah. We'll do two more. One more. And recover. Okay, we'll go back to windmill. So feet wide, arms are straight already. Opposite hand to opposite foot. Good. Let's do four more. One more. And relax. Okay, grab your pole again. And then back to this exercise. Get a nice stretch through the chest. Two more. Last one. Okay, drop it behind your head and rotate for me, side to side. Back to the center, over to the side, back up. Good. Try not to move your hips, try and keep your hips still. Good. So we're not kind of going like that with the hips. And you sit with your tighter on one side than the other. Oh, I definitely am. And recovery, okay, let go of that. Okay, and then we'll do the side to side, then down into ragdoll for me. Down one side, then the other. Yeah, relax. Okay, right. We're going to use the mat if you have one, and for the thoracic spine mobility, but don't worry if you don't have one. Right, hands together. We'll start here. We'll take a step to number four or left diagonal forwards. Get the weight onto that front leg, and then I want you to rotate, come back to the center. Then you'll go directly to the side, come back to the center, and then left diagonal. But as you go to the step to the back, go 90 degrees with the foot. So it's directly pointing out to the side. Pivot on that middle foot and back. Okay, have you got it? Bring the hands back down to the center every time. Keep the arms straight. And then 90 degrees on that back foot. Yeah. Okay, one more time through on this side for me. Good, and relax, shake the arms off, and then we'll go to the other side, keep the arms nice and straight. Okay, one more time through this side. I think it's 20 past already. One more. And relax. Shake it all off. There we go. That 20 minutes flew by. Thanks for coming, Amy. See you soon. See you later.